Colleagues, this is the Ethekwini business Indaba, where we as a city would like to engage with our stakeholders, the business, on the very important issues which are affecting our lives, affecting our businesses on a daily basis.
We are Ngeni Water's biggest customer, and we draw far more than most of our counterparts in the neighboring municipalities. Any savings made by Ethekwini are significant enough to benefit the dams.
As a city, we have implemented various water-saving measures, awareness campaigns, to encourage residents to reduce consumption.
Ultimately, our most urgent appeal to you now is to try and reduce your consumption. Let's achieve the 15% so that it will avoid the Department of Water and Sanitation from imposing further restrictions.
We are here to appeal to all of you to be champions of this change in behavior. Let us all become change agents. Let us all become champions of change. Let us become ambassadors on these water saving measures. Let us spread the message far and wide.
The way in which we aim to achieve that is through collaboration, where I've recently found out that the term in which we work is called swarming. And what that means is, like bees around a hive, as we form really specialist teams around a particular problem, and we basically facilitate that process. So I come from a chemical engineering background and spend a lot of time in the area of resource optimization, which covers energy, water and waste.
The actual value of water can often be up to 4 times in the process what the actual cost of the raw water coming into the site is. After you look at treatment, losses in the process, the energy content of the water and steam systems, effluent handling. So it's important to undertake a true think, or have spend proper time thinking about what is the true value of your water.
There's serious behavioural change that has to take place. And once you get an understanding of what enforcement of bylaws is, then you'll understand that as business and as all of us together, we have to get out there and change the behaviour of people on the ground.
We have recently embarked on a training, 8-month training with throughout the municipality and municipal workers as well. We've spent the last 3 months with Metro Police training them on our new nuisance bylaw as well as other bylaws. So I think that we have gained momentum and we are doing quite well.
You shall not erect a building or commence with the erection of a building, even commencing with earthworks, without prior approval of your building plans from the municipality.
The city can rely fully on the support of the Durban Chamber of Commerce in the implementation of the water restriction policies. We are there, we want to work with you, and we can always help with formal businesses who are not complying. And if we get it right, we can really have a 2022 Commonwealth Games where all of us can be truly proud of our city.
I promise, as a city, we are going to familiarize these kind of programs, because for now, as a start, it will give us an open eye to further more this